Hello, my dear friends. Welcome to my YouTube channel, Aditi, The Way of Learning. Today, the topic is memory organization. In this lecture, we will discuss a little bit about the memory and the cache memory, and other things we will discuss in the next upcoming video. So it is a part of computer architecture. So in this video, we will basically discuss about what is a memory, its hierarchy, types of hierarchy, what is a cache memory, types of cache memory, and locality of a reference. So first of all, we discuss what is a memory. We can say memory is simply a register, or we can say memory is simply a cell on which a data particular is stored, and each cell, or we can say register, is contain the address by which we can identify that particular memory block or address block or for a register for reading the data. So for example, it simply we represent a memory chip, simple representation. We just take a sake of example for simplicity. So in this example, this chip is contained total 64k number of they indicate the number of cells, total 64k kilo sets it contains, and each cell is size of 8 bits over here. So it simply means there are total number of 64k cells, and each cell size is 8 bits. So what is the capacity of that particular chip? So that the capacity of that particular chip is 64 kilobits. So what do you mean by is 8 bit is 1 byte. So we can say it is a 64 kilobytes. It's simply known as 64 kilobytes. After then, we can say that what is the data space itself? We simply say data space in cell. So what is the each cell contains? So each cell contains 8 bits. We already told in this example. And another thing, how we can access this chip data by using the address space. So we require total log 264k. It means total 16 bits are required to access total space of 64k. Bytes data space in particular chip. So it is a simple example of memory. So again, what is a memory? Nothing. It's simply a block of cells where data is stored. A small cell, we can say like that, and it accessed by using the address, the unique identification of particular cell. So this is another example of the same thing. If you are talking about a particular memory block units, it's simply a roughly out layout of this. So it simply contains, we can say, data lines. So it is a data lines where data, we can say, provides information to be stored in the memory, which provides information with data is to be stored in the memory. And then the control lines, what is the control line? Is specified direction of transfer. Control line simply says the data comes into the memory unit or data goes from the memory unit. And then the K address space line, this line is simply used to access a particular data in this memory block. And where K address lines, where 2 to power K memory words can be accessed. It means when the address space is a K, then it able to access 2 to the power K memory word in a particular memory chip. So it is simply basic example of memory block just for your understanding. So what is a memory? It's simply a block or cell where data is stored, a primary block. It is the smallest unit of particular memory, and it is accessed with the help of particular address. So in the next slide, we will simply discuss what is a memory hierarchy. So it is a, we can say everyone know about the things, what are types of memory. We can say primary memory, secondary memory. In the primary memory, there is also subcategories. In secondary memory, there are also very subcategories. So in this slides, we will mainly discuss levels of, or we can say hierarchy of particular memory. So in this diagram, we use a pyramid. Where pyramid apex is upper side. So it is simply say level 0, level 1, level 2, level 3, and level 4. We simply make 3 and 4, we can say both are the same. Let have a look and let me see. So the CPU, the central processing unit, simply contains itself a register. Register is the smallest block of memory, we just discussed in the previous slide. After then, there is a we can say cache memory. We discuss in upcoming video types of different memory. We can say internal primary memory or secondary memory, what kind of that and what is the variation of that. We will discuss. So after then, the level 2 is man memory, and the level 3 is magnetic disk, we can say secondary memory, and the optical disk, and then last is the magnetic tape. So you observe, the one thing is that this thing is very small. So size of register is small, and cache memory size is a little bit much bigger than the register, and main memory is much better than we can say much bigger than cache memory, and so on. So when we goes from bottom to up in the pyramid, the size is decreased, but the speed of particular we can say access time for the CPU to data access is very increased. What do you mean by say? So the data is stored in the register is fastly accessed as compared to the data stored in the cache memory. Similarly, data access by the CPU having in the cache memory is fast as compared to the man memory, and so on. So if the data is the levels 4, then time taken to access by the CPU is larger if the data is level 0. So this arrow simply shows from if it goes bottom to up, the increase in the cost of per bit, it means the unit of memory is increased. And when we go to the downward, it means when we go to the downward, that increase the capacity and access time. The capacity is increased, but the time of access to access the data by the CPU is also increased. So it really basically a description of the same level 0 register, it type of memory in which data is stored and access are they immediately stored in the CPU. Most commonly used register is a accumulator, program counter, address register, etc. Level 1 or cache memory, it is a faster memory which has faster access time where the data is temporarily stored or for fast access. And level 2 or man memory, it is a memory on which computer works currently. It is small in size, and once power is off, the data large stay in this memory, no longer stay in this memory. If it means if the data is in the main memory and the power will be off, then the data will be evaporated, it means a lost. Then the level 3 or 4 or second memory, it is an external memory which is not a fast, but we can say it contains the larger space of memory. It means it is a capacity is very large. So it is a hierarchy, it is very important, please remember that hierarchy. So in the next slide, this memory hierarchy can be divided into the two categories as we discuss. The we can say internal memory, or we can say internal memory, and we can say external memory. So internal memory is simply main memory, cache memory, CPU, register, etc. In our pyramid, the level 0, 1 or 2 are simply known as the internal memory. And the external memory, after the level 2, all the memory are known as external memory, like magnetic disk, optical disk, magnetic tape, peripheral storage devices, which are accessible by processor via input-output module. So external memory accessed by the CPU with the help of input-output module, and internal memory are reside inside a particular CPU, like registers, cache memory, etc. After moving forward, then the characteristics of particular memory hierarchy. So we already discussed capacity, access time, performance, and cost per bit. Let's have a look again. So what is the capacity? Capacity, it means it global volume of information memory can be stored, how much memory can be stored in a particular, we can say, a memory. So from the hierarchy, level 0 contains less number of memory space as compared to the upper level, like level 3 and 4 contain the larger volume of space. Access time is very fast in the level 0, 1. We can say level 0 is much faster than level 1, 2 and so on. And level 4 is very slower as compared to the level 0, 1, 2 and 3. Performance, again the performance, if the access time is faster, then the performance is also faster. So for the level 0, 1, 2, we can say level 0 is the most faster performance, then level 1 is little bit slower, and so on. Cost per bit, it means when we move toward the bottom to the up to the hierarchy, the cost per bit is increased, and internal memory is costlier than the external memory. It's simply a characteristic of particular cache memory. So Next. And next, what is the cache memory? Again, it is important topic. What is a cache memory? So cache memory, it's simply a memory which very nearly to the CPU. So we can say like it like our money in our wallet, it is just nearby in our hand. So it is a cache memory which is very nearest to the CPU, and all recent instruction are stored in a particular cache memory. So it is simply a diagram which shows it is our CPU which contains arithmetical logical unit and registers. The registers are temporary data storage space. So data comes to the CPU via cache memory, and it is a main memory. When we load any particular program into the computer, that it goes to the main memory. After the main memory, the data go to the cache memory, and that cache memory transfer the data to the register, and CPU use that register and perform the arithmetical logical operation and other read or write or something operation like that. So the data transfer from main memory to cache memory is simply known as a program or block transfer, and the cache to CPU, or we can say cache to register transfer data, is simply known as a bit by bit, because cache to register data is transferred by bit by bit. So what is a cache? It's simply nothing, but it's simply a nearest storage space which contains the recently instruction are stored in the particular cache memory. So all the recent action taken from the main memory and is stored into the cache memory. And cache memory is attached for storing the input which is given by the user and which is necessary for the CPU to perform the task. What do you mean by this? When a particular data is used by the CPU, the temporary is stored in the cache memory. And when it needed further, it is provided to the CPU. So next thing is, it's simply a terms which is used in the cache memory. Cache performance, it is also very important. So how we can perform a particular cache memory? So cache performance, when the processor need read or write data for a particular location, so CPU when need a particular data, it looks into the cache. If it find the data, is use it. When it find data, it's simply known as a hit. Hit, what do you mean by hit? Hit, it simply means when it looks a data into the cache and it find the data in particular cache. After that, we simply say, if data is found into the cache, it's okay. It's simply known as a cache hit. But if data is not found in a particular cache, then it's simply known as a cache miss. So what happened? If the cache is missed, then what happened? The cache memory take a data from the main memory, and from main memory it provide the data to the cache memory. So there is a two terms. One is a cache hit, when we find the data in the cache memory, and one is a cache miss, when we don't able to find the data in the cache memory by the CPU. Another term, what is a hit ratio? Hit ratio is nothing but simply a hit. Hit means total number of data, or we can say total number of things we are finding in the cache memory, and total number hits, we can say hit, cache hit, divided by total number hit or total number of miss. So total access, we can say. So CPU access the cache memory, if it is a find, that access is known as a hit. If it is not find, that access is known as a miss. So what is a hit ratio? Hit ratio is nothing but simply a hit, the number of total find out access, and divided by total hit and total miss, it's simply known as a hit ratio. So it is also one important formula which we will discuss in our next video related to the particular, we can say, question, numerical question we will did on it. So after toward it, we go to the next slide. So in the next slide, we simply discuss type of cache memory. We cannot say generally types of cache memory, but we simply convert it into that particular, say like that, primary memory, or we can say, primary cache or secondary cache. If we attach a cache memory with a particular CPU chip, then we simply say it is a primary cache. Or when we say it is apart from that a CPU chip, then it is simply known as a secondary cache. It's simply right way over here. Another thing is a locality of reference. It is also very important. What is the locality and what is the reference? So locality referents means another one question comes to your mind. The question is that the cache size is very small and the main memory size is larger as compared to the cache. How, which data is cache will be stored from the main memory so that the CPU can able to access or CPU can hit a particular data which it required. So it is very important. So on the basis of two criteria, that cache memory contains the data from the main memory. The one criteria is a special locality reference and another one is a temporal locality reference. What do you mean this? Special locality reference, it means, suppose it is stated that if the data object is referred to the ones, then there is a high probability that neighbor data object will also be referred in the near future. What do you mean by this? Suppose CPU accesses a particular data in a particular location, then nearby that location data is also used, is maybe used by the CPU. So that is simply known as spatial locality reference. So the CPU, or we can say the cache memory, contain the data which nearby the data which currently used. Another second variation is the temporal locality of reference. It means, suppose a particular data is used by the CPU, after used by that, in future it may be used by the CPU. So that particular cache contain the data in itself, contain data in set, that is simply known as the temporal data locality. You can say temporal data locality state that the same data object are likely to be reused multiple times by the CPU during the execution of a program. Once a data object has been written in the cache on the first miss, a number of subsequent hit on that object can be expected. It means once data is not found over there, then maybe in future it will need that particular CPU. That CPU, so cache memory take in itself and it contain for the future that maybe CPU use for use a computation for ALU performance. So it is we can say locality of the references. So all, in next video we will discuss about mapping of the cache memory. It is very important for the exam point of view and also for the gate point of view. Mapping, we will discuss the three types of mapping in the cache. And if you are having any query, so please post in this video. If you are having any query, then your query will be posted in particular comment box. I definitely try to solve you. Thank you. Thank you very much.